We may be perceived as a clean, green country, but we have big problems. Around 2.5 million tonnes of waste is still going to landfills each year. On Anmarmpedia Pro 3 Coffee Group, we are talking about reducing our household waste with Nick Turner and Kate Meads. Good morning to you both.
Good morning.
Lovely to have you here. Let's start with you, Nick. For most families, not unusual to fill a wheelie bin with rubbish each week. In fact, I would probably even go over that. What should our goal be?
Yes. To me, the most important thing is just to be more conscious or more aware or more mindful of the waste we're creating and how we're consuming, I guess, and then to focus on literally just one small change that you can make to reduce your waste. Everybody's in a really different place and capable of really different things, so, and it can also get really overwhelming. So if you start by just going, what's one small change I can make, and focus on that, it's really achievable, and then it motivates you to make more change.
Which is a great idea, because you do, I look at our bin and just think there's just so much packaging everywhere. Kate, what are the easiest first steps, do you think, to reducing waste?
I think it's just simple day-to-day goals, like, you know, things like reusable coffee cups, just an easy change that can be a day-to-day, a huge impact changer. Also straws, just simple things. You don't have to go out and start, you know, doing everything overnight. Just starting with one thing that you commit to is really important. And then, you know, for example, you know, if everybody just, if you use a takeaway coffee cup Monday to Friday and then change to a reusable one, it's about 260 coffee cups that don't go to landfill a year just by going to a reusable.
And that's if you just have the one cup of coffee.
Just one
per
cup
day.
Of coffee.
It's funny that, because I do use a reusable coffee cup, and it's when I forget it, I feel really bad. It's really unusual, and it feels really strange to be, you know, getting a proper coffee cup. Also, Nick, let's talk about kids' school lunches. Sometimes when you're trying to sort them out with packaging and everything, what could we do differently there?
So yeah, lots of again easy sort of small changes you can make. So I use those compartment style lunch boxes because that's a really easy way to not have to use any additional packaging, so then you can skip the cling film or the tin foil or the lunch wrap. Exactly. We also have sort of evolved to eating a lot more real food, you know, then that naturally doesn't come in packaging. And then I have also found having a mindset of bulk is a really good way to approach it. It saves you time, it saves you money, and also massively reduces your packaging waste. So it could be something as simple as going, I'm going to buy the biggest tub of yogurt and then serve that down into reusable containers for the lunchbox. Or instead of buying the little multi-packs of chips, I'm going to buy a big bag and sort of split those down. And if you're baking, double, triple, quadruple that recipe and fill the freezer. You know, when I cook dinner, I'll always cook more, and that becomes the core of the family lunchboxes for the next day.
I've got three boys though, so we don't actually have
any leftovers.
I cook quadruple, they just eat quadruple. Kate, let's talk about food waste. Is it possible to compost when you're in a small city house or an apartment?
Oh yeah, there's so many options. I mean, if you've got a bit of land in the backyard, just a compost bin is so simple, just chuck it all in there and it disappears. You've got your Bokashi system, which is great for apartments. Really low smell, really compact, and you can keep it in the kitchen. And then if you want to go out worm farming, that's quite exciting too. People think that's really hard, but you don't have to, like, you can talk to the worms if you want to, but like they literally just work on their own. You don't have to like go out and move their fences or anything, you just put the food in there.
And that's where you go.
Exactly.
You you don't have to farm the sort of thing. Nick, just quickly, what other habits do you think we could change?
Yeah, so to me it's having that consciousness or that awareness in everything we consume and just sort of taking that micro pause to see if there's another way. So things like toys, you have kids and all of a sudden your house is full of toys. So the way we do it is very much a less is more approach. We belong to a toy library, we swap with friends. If we do buy, we buy second hand. We focus on experiences over things. Clothing, we often don't think of the waste that's associated with clothing. Very similar approach, less is more. I will predominantly buy second hand for myself and the children and swap. And then pretty much anything else, like even personal care. So we started with a raft of products like this. We went, do we really need all of those, or can we sort of have multi-purpose ones?
Yeah. I could talk about this all day, but we've run out of time, unfortunately. Op shopping is so good. Hey, thank you both very much for joining us today. Really inspiring stuff. Kate and Nick, thank you.
Thank you.
The Coffee Group is brought to you by Anmarmpedia Pro 3, the only toddler milk with no added sugars. Now, if you have any worries that you'd like addressed by our parenting panel, message us on the Cafe Facebook page. One contributor will win this very cool ebook from Anmarm that allows you
Good night, Mel. Here's a story just for you.
To record your own voice, how cool is that? Congratulations to this week's winner, Amanda Jane Fuller. Your ebook is on its way.